is it's really important to regulate the rate at which you filter. Remember, every minute, about 1,200 cc's of blood is filtered through your kidneys. In other words, that filtration rate, the amount of filtrate formed per minute by the two kidneys combined, right, is going to be, out of that 1,200 cc's, we get about 125 milliliters a minute of filtrate. In other words, 125 milliliters of fluid comes through into my tubule, right, every minute. And that's a good rate. But if you think about it, that's your kidneys are working pretty hard, right? So every minute, one of your kidneys has to filter through and create about this much filtrate. So they're working very hard every single minute. But this is good. This is a good functioning kidney. So every minute, 125 milliliters of filtrate comes through. The reason why your kidney is able to filter is because of blood pressure. Right? So do you guys remember, what's a good systolic and diastolic blood pressure for us? 120 over 80, right? Remember that 120 is from the ventricles contracting really hard and pushing the blood, ejecting the blood out. It's that pressure from the 120 that's forcing the blood to go all the way through to the glomerulus in the kidney. Right? So it's that systolic pressure that's giving you the force to push the blood through and filter properly. So we want to figure out, okay, how do we make sure we keep up that pressure? Here's the problem. If we start filtering too fast, let's say your kidney's like on overdrive and it's filtering really fast and a lot, you're going to start to lose a lot of the needed substances to urine. So in other words, like that water, that glucose, the sodium, the chloride, if it's going through too fast, it's going to stay in the tube and you're going to urinate it out. If it's too slow, the problem is we're going to start to retain more waste in the blood. And you're not going to get rid of all of the excess stuff. For example, I'm sure you guys have all been in like a grocery store checkout line. Right? You put all your groceries on the conveyor belt and you're just waiting there. What do they put right by the conveyor belt?
Impulse purchases.
What do they put there when you're waiting in line? Candy. What else is there? Magazines, right? Do you really need that stuff? No. But because you're just hanging around there, they want you to look at it and buy this excess stuff, right? So if you move too slowly through that checkout line, you're going to start to look and think, oh, I'll take that candy bar, right? I'll take that magazine. And you start getting more stuff that you want that you don't need. It's the same thing here. If your filtrate is going through too slow, you're going to start to reabsorb actually some of the waste too. Oh, I've got time. I'll take that back. Oh, I'll take that back. So you'll start retaining more of the waste in your blood instead of letting it pass through and end up in the urine. Right? So you don't want to go too slow. You want to go just the right speed. Just the right speed actually ends up being about 10 millimeters of mercury. Just to correlate that, remember you guys, the systolic pressure generally is 120. Remember, 120 is right when it comes out of the heart. So imagine if your blood is coming out of the heart at 120 millimeters of mercury of pressure, by the time it makes its way all the way back to the kidney, remember, pressure drops, it'll drop to about 10. That's good. About 10 is a good amount of pressure to make sure your kidneys are filtering at the right rate. Okay, so let me show you guys actually a good illustration. So I explained what happens if your blood goes by too slow, right? You start picking up weight. Here is an example of what happens if it goes by too fast. Okay. You guys know I Love Lucy? Mm-hmm. So I haven't seen all the episodes, but this is a classic. And again, this is the scenario if you're filtering too fast. To grab it back and you'll lose it. Right? So again, too fast is not good. Too slow, also not good. We want to be just the right pace. Okay. So you don't want to lose the good stuff. Alright. So how many of you guys have heard of renal failure? Yep. Okay. Renal stands for kidney. And then failure is it's not working. Acute just means like right now, temporarily. So what acute renal failure is when you don't have enough blood pressure to make the kidneys filter. So if the kidneys aren't filtering your blood, they're not doing their job, they're failing. So let's take a look and see if you guys can figure this out. What do you think acute renal failure is? Is it A, the glomerular filtration rate is too low? B, the glomerular filtration rate is too high? Or C, sorry, three, glomerular filtration rate is in homeostasis? One, two, or three. Your kidneys are failing to filter. Good. I'm seeing mostly one. One is the correct answer. If your filtration rate is too low, your kidneys are not filtering your blood well enough. So that's the problem. So notice how your blood pressure is directly related to how well your kidneys function. If your blood pressure drops too low, you could risk going into renal failure because you don't have enough pressure to filter your blood. Okay, so this gets us into thinking, well, let's make sure then we can still filter appropriately given our blood pressure. So you guys know that your blood pressure changes all the time, right? 120 over 80 is if you're just sitting and chilling at rest. But you guys know from lab, when you start to do things, right, your blood pressure can automatically change. So, for example, sympathetic nervous system, right? What state are you in when you're in your sympathetic nervous system? Fight or flight. So what happens to your heart rate? Increases. So what's going to happen to your blood pressure? It's also going to increase, right? So then you guys start to have problems. Well, if my blood pressure starts to increase, then my filtration rate's going to change. So we're going to look and see what happens. What happens when you go above, let's say 180, right? You should be about 120. What happens when you go above 180? Or what if the other extreme? What happens when you drop too low? Like, for example, below 80. Too low would be, too high would be, for example, fight or flight, right? Too low would be, for example, when you go into heart failure, right? And we said, hey, congestive heart failure, you can't circulate your blood well. In either of these scenarios, let's think about it. In this scenario, where do you want your blood to be? Why is this person laying down with the legs up?
The core.
Where do you want to direct the blood? Yeah, to the heart, right? And the lung, the core organ, right? Do you really think your priority here is making the blood go to the kidneys? No, not in this scenario, right? In this scenario, we want to make sure the blood is at the heart and the lung. How about in this scenario, when you're running away? Where do you put most of your blood when you're running? Yeah, your skeletal muscles, right? So you can move. So again, in this scenario, your priority is not to bring your blood to your kidneys. So in both of these cases, right, these extreme scenarios, we actually don't want the blood going to the kidney because we have other priorities. So let's see how we can make sure that happens. All right, so our goal is to redirect the blood. In other words, lower the glomerular filtration rate, lower the rate of the blood going to the kidney. Right? So let's take the scenario when we start off with we're in our fight or flight, our sympathetic nervous system. In this particular case, what's going to happen is you have norepinephrine release, right? What's norepinephrine? Yeah, it's just adrenaline, right? So you get your adrenaline kick. What the adrenaline does is it travels to the afferent arteriole. The afferent arteriole is the blood vessel coming into my glomerulus. So this is my afferent arteriole. So what's going to happen is you're going to constrict that afferent arteriole coming into my glomerulus, coming into my kidney. When you constrict a blood vessel, right, and it gets smaller, what happens to the amount of blood that can flow through?
Lower,
right? If your blood vessel gets smaller, less blood can go through. So my blood flow is going to lower going into my glomerulus. If I have less blood flowing in, that reduces or lowers my glomerular filtration rate. So now I can make sure my blood goes to the other places, like my skeletal muscles instead. Okay. Questions on that? All right. Now, let's say you're in class. You're sitting, you're relaxing, your blood pressure is normal. But let's say after class, you go and you walk to your next class. When you get up and start walking, what's going to happen to your blood pressure? It's going to increase a little bit, but not drastically, right? But just a little bit. What happens at night when you go to sleep? What happens to your blood pressure? It's going to go down, but again, not drastically, right? Just a little bit. So in both of these cases, whether you go for a walk or whether you go to sleep, you still want to make sure your kidneys are working, right? So in these scenarios, you want to make sure that your glomerular filtration rate is relatively constant. These are all just kind of standard, hey, I'm going through my day. So for the normal standard range, about 80 to 180 millimeters of mercury for the systolic pressure, you want to make sure that your kidneys are auto-regulating. In other words, that your glomerular filtration rate is staying relatively constant. So let's see if you guys can explain how your kidney does this. I'm going to give you guys the key guidelines here and see what happens. Let's say, take the example when you get up and you go for a walk and your blood pressure rises a little bit. See if you can walk through and explain to your classmate how at the very end you make sure that your glomerular filtration rate doesn't go up with your blood pressure. Right? So again, use this guideline and see if you can explain it. And then think about, is this positive or negative feedback? Okay. So go ahead, take a few minutes talking with your classmates and walk through.